Thank you. Hello everyone and welcome to N17 Live. Welcome back to Tottenham Hotspur Stadium on what is a hugely exciting evening. One of our own, Ryan Mason, taking charge of the first team for the first time tonight. In about 45 minutes time, Spurs will be taking on Southampton. Let me just give you the lay of the land very quickly there. Spurs seventh in the table, but a win tonight would take us to within 2 points of the Champions League position. Southampton 14th. They come into this one off the back of losing the semi-final of the FA Cup, so a really interesting one for them tonight, and lots to look forward to on the show this evening. Rob Daly, our club commentator, is going to be in with me very shortly to talk through Ryan Mason's first 11 that he's put up this evening. We'll also be talking to Timu Taino, one of the winners of the League Cup in 08, to get his experiences and his thoughts ahead of a huge match weekend for Spurs this Sunday, taking on Man City in the League Cup final. And we'll also have all of your match day favourites as well. Not long to go now until Ryan Mason's Spurs take on Southampton. So a massive welcome to the show then, everyone, on what promises to be a really exciting evening for Spurs fans. And I'm delighted to say we're joined by club commentator Rob Daly. How are you, Rob?
Good, Ben. How are you?
Yeah, good. Busy couple of days, but I have to say I am so excited to see Ryan Mason in the dugout tonight. Seeing him arrive was really special.
Yeah, I mean, clearly you could see in his press conference yesterday and in his interview with Spurs TV that he's just absolutely buzzing to be in this position. A man who's had an affiliation with this club for more than two decades now, and obviously he had his time away at Hull and his time out of football, and then he was straight back into football with Spurs. So a great occasion for him and the whole coaching staff tonight, which I think we'll get on to.
Yeah, I can't wait to talk about that. Should we just see the arrivals and go through the team news first, because I guess that's the thing everyone's waiting for, right, to see who Ryan Mason's gone for in his first 11. So Ryan comes into this one, as Rob said, with an incredibly exciting dugout. Leddy King, Chris Powell, Michelle Vorman, Nigel Gibbs in there with him. He's been managing within our youth setup for a long time, done a wonderful job, and you may have seen him on the show earlier on this season. As Rob said, very much one of our own, and what a week he has ahead of him. Southampton tonight, but then leading Spurs out in a League Cup final at Wembley at the weekend. So let's have a look who he's gone for in that starting 11 this evening, and how exciting is this? He's gone Lloris, Aurier, Alderweireld, Dier and Reguilon. But then the midfield three, I have to say on a personal level, I'm so excited to watch Ndombele, Højbjerg and Lo Celso, very attack-minded, and Lucas Son and Bale. No Harry Kane tonight, not fit just yet, but obviously still waiting to see whether he might be involved in the weekend. Dele on the bench, I'm sure we'll be seeing a bit of him tonight, and a number of other attacking options. Rob, first thoughts on that?
Yeah, attacking changes, because it's worth noting who's come out of the 11 tonight. So Joe Roden, centre-back, of course. Moussa Sissoko, who I think we can all agree is a more defensive-minded centre midfield player. And then Kane, after his injury late against Everton. We hope he'll be fine. Everything.
Right, yeah. Cross, touch wood, everything.
He's OK for Sunday. I imagine it will be Sonny leading the line tonight up front. And Ryan Mason was talking about daring and being attacking in his pre-match press conference, and I'm sure that's what a lot of the team selections come down to. Another thing I wanted to point out quickly, Ben, was that I was watching some videos of Chris Powell talking about his coaching philosophy and work previously, and when he stepped in as Southend boss when they had been struggling. And he said what he did immediately was they'd gone on a run of defeats, but he went back to the games when they last played well and analysed those performances and immediately tried to implement the tactics that was used in those games into that. And I wonder if they've looked back and gone, that stretch where Bale and Lucas were all on fire with Kane and Son, and thought that's probably the best way to start out.
It was a really great period, that one. We'll just have a quick look at Southampton. So they come into this one off the back of a bit of a rough weekend in the FA Cup semi-final. Only 9 points above Fulham in the Premier League, and they've lost 7 of their last 8 Premier League away games. We can see Ralf Hasenhüttl's starting 11 now. And there's probably a couple of ways that you can read this, but it could be a 3-5-2. Walker, Peters, Bednarek, Vestergaard, Salisu and Teller perhaps making up a 3 or a 5 there, with Armstrong and Ward-Prowse behind Walker, Adams and Ings. So just a quick thought on that, Rob. Just first thing that jumps out at you there.
Attack. Again, Southampton are replying with attack. I mean, part of the issue that Ralf Hasenhüttl had with his side's performance, the defeat to Leicester in the FA Cup semi-final, was that they lacked... He felt it was one of their worst ever performances under him in an attacking sense. They certainly looked limp going forward and creating chances. So into the team tonight, we're seeing loads of attacking players, including... Theo Walcott, Che Adams, who's actually on 7 goals this season, along with the likes of Ings and Teller and Armstrong. I mean, that's 2 strikers and 3 attacking midfielders for me. I think Stuart Armstrong predominantly is an attacking midfielder. So I think that's what they're going for tonight
very,
as well.
Very open game ahead, yeah, I'm sure. Yeah. We're going to come on to talk a little bit more about the team news, but first, let's hear Ryan Mason's first ever interview with Spurs TV.
It's a massive, massive honour. I love the club. I think the fans, I think everyone associated with the club knows how much this club means to me. I've been associated with the club over 20 years as a player, obviously as a coach as well.
You just have to be prepared and ready for what football can throw at you at times. Obviously, I had the experience of having to retire. There was a lot of difficult moments, but the most important thing was my attitude.
I'm going to do all I can to do the club proud. We have some exceptional players. I've got personal relationships with them from my playing days. They're a good group, they want to work, and the last 2 days have been very positive.
Playing for Tottenham Hotspur, we have a beautiful stadium. We have some things to play for, some big things as well. I want us to play like Tottenham Hotspur, to be brave, to be aggressive. That's what we want Tottenham to be like. That's how I've known it as a player. That's huge for our fans to feel like our players represent us. The fans are such a huge part of this football club. I think the most important thing now is to get the players in the right frame of mind, give them some key principles of how we want to approach games of football, and then hopefully as that goes on, that can develop.
The most important thing for us is to focus on ourselves, to compete, to run, to fight, and then also feel like we have the freedom to go and express ourselves. I'm looking forward to hopefully helping the football club.
I have to say, as a Spurs fan, that like it catches you right in the feels. Like that, there's an image in there of Ledley King and Ryan Mason sort of turned facing training together, standing side by side, and it just really catches you. You have to sort of like snap out of it a bit. It's such a lovely image.
Well, what I understand is there has been a very Spurs feeling around the training ground in the past couple of days. Obviously, due to the makeup of the coaching staff, Nigel Gibbs has worked at Spurs before, very experienced assistant coach, but already was affiliated with Spurs and had been back in a little bit. Chris Powell himself says he was a boyhood Spurs fan, got him in the dugout alongside Ledley, a club legend. And then, of course, if things had worked out differently for Ryan, he could have been a player at Spurs for a longer time. He was unfortunate at the back end of his Spurs time before he moved on to Hull. Pochettino loved him. If anyone's read Pochettino's book, they clearly thought a lot of each other, and he was sad to have to let Mason depart eventually, of course, to Hull, where his career ended. But, you know, I think as well, you know, there's been the question, can a 29-year-old and a former teammate of these players, some of them like Ben and Sonny and Harry Kane, get authority out of the group? And I think he has. I think they'll believe in him, and with the authority of the likes of Powell around him as well, it's a good blend for the rest of the season.
I think it's so interesting what you say. We saw Harry Kane tweet a little bit earlier on today just saying they'll give everything for Ryan Mason. And it's such a finite window from now until the end of the season. No one knows what's going to happen after 7 games' time. But when you know you've got that window of opportunity, there's so many players now that have got a fresh start and an opportunity to go again.
Yeah, the likes of Dele, of course, who hasn't had a great deal of game time. Harry Winks, who maybe positionally was at times similar to Ryan Mason himself, has only made 7 Premier League starts. So there are fresh opportunities for a lot of the guys. Saying that, there isn't a lot of time. If they strike upon a winning formula tonight or something that they think they can go into the Carabao Cup final in, that will probably be what they'll try and stick to the remainder of the season. Of course, it's Harry to come back in, but... The team selection for me is very logical tonight. And when you haven't got long to implement complex ideas, I think it's a strong 11.
We could see Ryan taking coach in there. And I think often with the idea of getting discipline and keeping hold of discipline within a squad, there's a couple of ways of doing it. I mean, you can get discipline through being someone that screams and shouts. You can get discipline by people having respect for you and what you've achieved and the type of character that you are. And I really get the impression that with people like Ledley alongside him, that he's absolutely the sort of person that Spurs could do it right now. Yeah. Should we just have a quick look at him in action playing for Spurs as well? I mean, this is for a lot of Spurs fans. So we need no reminding of what a player that he was. But a couple of lovely goals in here midfield.
He had a great time at Spurs. It was during
he
time.
He was in such a sweet spot, wasn't he?
He was, and I think he's admitted that. I think he said around that time of the League Cup final, when he was in the side and everything, I think he was saying that was sort of the peak of his powers. Got his England cap. I think 2015, 16, I forget the exact year. You know, he and in his head, and from what I understand the way he coaches on the touchline, he still sees himself as a player. Obviously, he couldn't continue his career, had to retire officially just over 3 years ago now. But I think he's got that hunger and desire, and if he could drop himself into centre mid with Pierre-Emile Højbjerg,
he probably would. It was so dramatic in the training. He's still kicking balls around, yeah. He's still very much involved. Let's just get ourselves in the mood for some goals tonight with that attack-minded lineup in mind with 6 and 60 against Southampton.
They go early with the ball to Son. McCarthy, Dithers on his line, and it's been made to pay. Heung-min Son with a wonderful finish. There's wing backs. Here goes Sessegnon bursting through the middle. He's still got it. And Ndombele, it's into the net.
It's Davis. Nice clip ball over the top of Delap, and this is it. This has got to be it.
This is wonderful football. Kane to finish. Wow, what a goal from Spurs. Exceptional.
Spurs with a chance now on the break. Into Ruul Fox. Ruul Fox, and he's done it. Super strike from Fox.
Some brilliant goals in there. Really, really great to see some great goals from the archive. Let's just remind you what's coming up on the show tonight. Timu Taino is our special guest. He's going to be joining us to talk through the League Cup win of 08 and just give us a steer on what we can look forward to this weekend amongst a lot of your other match day favourites as well. We're going to be taking a look now at a few players that we think may feature in some capacity tonight, but also have a real opportunity now with Ryan Mason coming in taking charge. Let's start with Dele. You mentioned him before, Rob. With a more attack-minded system, someone like Dele could potentially really feature in this last 6 or 7 game window, couldn't he?
Yeah, we actually thought at one point, I think under there was a point a month and a half ago where we thought, oh, Dele has actually been reintegrated into the starting 11. He made his second Premier League start of the campaign against Fulham and did relatively well in that game. We thought he had scored the only goal of the game, but it was technically an own goal. But he's going to have to fight because obviously we know that Tongyeon Ndombele in his central advanced midfield position has been very good this season. He's dropped back, granted, but just in time for Lo Celso's return from injury over the past months. Past 3 or 4 months that Lo Celso's been out. So Dele has some work to do, I think, you know, to integrate himself back into the team. Ledley King has obviously been seeing him in first team training as well, so can give Ryan Mason a steer on where he is and how much value he thinks he has for the remaining, what is it, 7 games of the season.
Yeah, so 6 in the Prem and then the game in the League Cup final.
Yeah, just a little League Cup final on Sunday.
Yeah, just a small thing like that this Sunday. let's talk Gareth Bale. So for me, I will be unwavering in this. I absolutely love seeing Gareth Bale in a Spurs shirt. And there is a huge part of me that is just got everything crossed that Bale will, over the course of this next 6 games in the league at least, just show everyone that the undeniable quality that he has and that we saw earlier on in the season in that 4-5 game win.
I mean, he was scintillating in that spell. I'll confess, off the back of the international break, I understood the decision maybe not to play him in the first game away at Newcastle. We all know that there is management of Gareth Bale. Gareth Bale's given a degree of control over his own fitness and where he thinks he is going into games. Then I thought, oh, he'll come back in for Manchester United. He didn't. I was thinking, oh, maybe he'll come back in for Everton and didn't. So I'm delighted to see him back in the starting 11. There were times in that run, I think it was Burnley at home and everything, where he was just, everything he did was progressive play, attacking, dangerous passes, 30, 40 yards, stretching opposition. And of course his finishing was effortless at that time. He was just pinging balls down that south stand.
That right hand side and then feeding him into the corner. Yeah. Like, another one of them tonight, please, Gareth, would be an absolute treat. Let's go on to talk a little bit about Tanguy Ndombele, because you mentioned that he's been the one really that cemented that advance sort of midfield role, or been very good in that advanced midfield role, but also can play a little bit deeper and do the shuttle role as well, helping out Pierre-Emile Højbjerg. What do you think we'll see him tonight?
Yeah, I think we'll see him alongside Højbjerg predominantly. It'll be interesting to see if it'll sort of break off. So Højbjerg plays in front of that back four, and then the other two are wide to him. You described it as maybe a midfield three. It could easily be that. It could be Lo Celso in the 10. They maybe have looked back at the tapes of when Spurs were really flying and go, well, when Lucas Moura was in the 10.
In the 10, yeah.
He was absolutely killing it. And Son, Bale, Kane and Lucas as a four were brilliant. So maybe it's Lucas in the 10. It might be Lo Celso wide. That's not completely out of the question. That's why I think we'll see Ndombele probably out of the three central midfielders alongside Højbjerg a little bit deeper. But yeah, when he gets going, it's a joy.
It is. It's sort of, there's times, isn't there, where you can just get a little bit lost in watching him and just think, like, this is just a guy having fun.
Just ridiculous step-overs. I mean, the other day against Everton, it wasn't happening for him. You know, normally he's just doing these step-overs and guys are falling over and he's running around.
It was strange.
It was weird. You could see he was looking at it like, oh, I've lost my powers tonight. It wasn't quite clicking. So he has the best dribbling stats in the Spurs team this season, the seventh best in the whole Premier League, and for a central midfielder, not a winger, that's not bad going. So let's see if he can make those runs tonight.
Let's have a watch of some more goals and remind ourselves of five special goals from earlier on in the season against Southampton.
Come on, Alex! They go early with the ball to Son. McCarthy did this on his line and it's been made to pay. Lo Celso, Kane, Son. Springs away from Stevens and Son has scored again. All over the top, is Son in again, flag stays down, Gunminson on a hat-trick, gets it! Kane and Son, who's up with him, he's worked it into Son again, I do not believe it, it is brilliant! Here's Lamella, he shoots, it's against the post and Kane's there to score now.
Some fantastic goals in there. Let's have a little talk about Southampton, Rob.
Yeah.
Because I think they're a really interesting side. There's a lot of huge fans of Hasan Hüttl and the way that he plays. But for whatever reason, it's just not really happened for them this season, has it?
No, and in particular, I mean, that game was something of an anomaly, actually. If you remember at the start of the season, Southampton were actually doing pretty well. They were flirting around the Europa League, Champions League, those kind of places. But they have completely fallen away. They have the worst record in the Premier League in 2021. They've picked up 10 points or something to that effect since the turn of the calendar year.
I think that's the worst record in the
That's right, that's right. And Danny Ings also hasn't scored as many. I mean, I was looking at his numbers today, 9 Premier League goals. You go, that's good, but it's probably not enough, and certainly not enough maybe to get him into the Euro squad. So there's a combination of factors. Their squad is thin for me, and it was going into the start of the season. They were certainly light in central midfield, particularly after the departure of Højbjerg. They fixed the right-back problem. They're all raving about Walker Peters. I think they're very happy with their side of the deal. Spurs fans very happy with their side of the deal. But I wonder if the rigours, maybe of being in the FA Cup for a prolonged period as well, have just stretched quite a small squad to its limits.
Let's talk a little bit about Kyle Walker-Peters, because he's someone that I mean, everyone loves seeing an academy prospect come through, but he's someone I really have enjoyed watching at Southampton as well.
Now, he's been great. I mean, and I think he's pretty adamant. He's had a fantastic time. I remember at the back end of last season, I was just dipping into a Southampton podcast to get the general vibe, and they were loving him. They were desperate to keep him at right back. You never know. England at right back are stacked. Whether one day Kyle Walker-Peters could play for England, I do not think it's out of the question.
I think you could pick 11 right-backs for England at the moment. It's just ridiculous.
It's crazy. But he's a very special player, and it's great to see him back at Tottenham Hotspur.
You mentioned Danny Ings a little bit earlier on as well. He's someone that has caused trouble for us in the past.
Understatement. I mean, his finishing is, I mean, he's a natural finisher. It's a cliche, but it's absolutely the case. His goal against Liverpool this season, where he looped it over Alisson, was really special, and he got two in the 5-2, got one here last season, right in the Premier League, scored in the home game at St Mary's. Did he score in the FA Cup as well?
The FA Cup, where he sort of fed it into the corner.
That's right, yeah. Five in five against Spurs. Yeah, he's in the mood. Of course, there's question marks over his future. He's got a year left after this season. There'll be a lot of clubs that would love Danny Ings on their books. So see if him and Che Adams, who's been improved this season in the Premier League, can do some damage.
Right, look into your crystal ball, Rob. Tell me how it's going to play out tonight.
I think, Ryan Mason's first ever game as a coach was here with the under-18s against Southampton. 3-1, Oliver Skip, you know, bossing it in the Championship in central midfield. So I'm going to go exact same score, superstitious, 3-1 Spurs.
Can I just ask you to go a little bit deeper on that as well? I'd like to know how you think it's going to play tactically. Do you think Spurs are going in that with a three, or do you think they're going to go with the sort of 4-2-4?
If I had to guess, I'd go Lucas Moura will play the 10. If they've gone back to the old footage and decided that's the way to go, and then maybe Lo Celso out wide. But I'm probably completely wrong. I have no idea.
Well, at least we're getting closer to predicting the starting lineup.
That's true.
Thank you so much, Ray. It's been great to have you.
Cheers, Ben.
And we'll catch you a little bit later on.
Cool.
Let's now just go and see our very special guest in action, our League Cup winner from 08 and a very, very wonderful character. So welcome to the show, TB Tainio. How are you, mate? You well?
Hi, Ben. Yeah, thank you. I'm really good, thank you. I was just watching those two goals. Was that all of my goals from Prem? The clip was so short.
No way. Loads more.
Yeah, I know.
TB, just firstly, tell us how you are and how you've been getting on. It's obviously been a weird year, but just talk me through it. How have you been getting on back home?
Yeah, I'm back. I'm coaching my old team where I used to play before I left my European tour. And we are still on the pre-season here in Finland. The pre-season is 6 months. So we are getting closer to the start of the season. The season should start in the beginning of May. So little by little, we are getting ready. But it's been really, really weird season. And I can feel the fans in England. It's when I watch the games, Premier League games in here in TV. It's nothing compared when there's people on the ground.
Not the same, is it? Not the same at all.
No, definitely.
And Timo, I suppose with the League Cup final coming up this weekend, you've been seeing a lot of your old teammates, haven't you? Just tell me how it's been catching up with all the guys from 2008.
Yeah, it's been great. We've been talking with Tom Huddleston, Michael Dawson, Paul Robinson lately, and yeah, it's been great. I haven't see them on live, I don't know, 10 years maybe. So it's been really, 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 really good last few weeks. And I'm hoping these kind of things will get more and more. But I'm also hoping that the next year they are this year's team, because they're going to win Sunday. So
yeah,
we can be fast now.
Amazing. Just tell us your memories of 2008. I mean, it was an incredible run to the final, beating Arsenal in the semis as well, but then to beat Chelsea in the final was so special, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was definitely. I always said that my time in Spurs was my highlight of my career, because I was a Spurs fan since a little kid. But that was the cherry on the cake, of course, the winning something with your boyhood favourite club. So it was really a special moment for me and everybody else.
Timmy, just tell me a little bit about that, because it might be something that not all Spurs fans know, but you were a Spurs fan, so coming to Spurs was incredibly special for you.
Yeah, it was actually. When I left, I played 7 years in France, then I had a few chances few clubs were asking me from the Prem, and I agreed to come to Spurs. And one other club's manager called me that whatever they're going to pay you in Spurs, we double it, come here. I said, no way, my heart is already in London. Thank you, but no thank you.
Oh, I love that. That's so lovely. And I mean, you were part of some incredible games, but the one that I picked out that I thought we should talk about tonight, as well as the League Cup final, was the 4-3 against West Ham. Can you remember that night? You scored that evening. How special was that one?
Yeah, it was a really special game. I remember, I can't remember, was it a 2-1 goal for West Ham, or because I was marking one of the biggest strikers in the set pieces, and he scores. I said, no, we can't lose because of this goal. And then we got, then finally we got the win. And it was one of my most memorable Premier League games for me. I managed to score also, so it was something special.
Timmy, what advice would you give to the players this weekend? We go in against Man City, who are leading the way in the Premier League. I'm not going to say we're underdogs, but they're a very, very good side. So what advice would you give to the players this time around?
My advice would be that go for the game, go for it, because we all know Man City, the quality they have. If you're only sitting back and waiting them to come at you, at some point they will score. And if you think about the Tottenham players at the moment, there's so many offensive-minded players. So I'm really hoping that Ryan will get the boys flying Sunday, starting today, but Sunday especially, and
100%.
Really going for it.
Yeah, so just give me, to finish up, team, just give me your score prediction for tonight. I know you've seen the team news. You must be very excited. What do you reckon it's going to be tonight?
Yeah, it's going to be 2-0 and Gareth Bale both goals.
Yeah, brilliant shout. Brilliant shout. Timmy, thank you so much for joining us tonight. So great to see you.
Always a pleasure.
We'll hopefully see you again very, very soon. Take care.
See you, Ben. Bye, bye, bye.
What an absolute legend. Love him so much. And a great story in there about joining the club as well. Let's just jump into the archive now and remind ourselves of a classic 4-1 win for Spurs against the Saints.
Brought in by Ward-Prowse. Header has gone in. Again, and that wasn't far away. There's Redmond with the shot. And Ballet again. Ali with the header. It's there. Dele Alli, out of nothing. Oh, the Southampton defence seemed to stand still. Played over by Dembele. Soko's ball found its way through to Dele Alli. Good touch. Still going, Wanyama! Denied by that challenge from Font. There's the header! Oh, yes! Harry Kane! Another cross, another header, another goal. And Harry Kane reaches double figures for the season. Counter-attack's on, look at Heung-Min Son go. Chance for Heung-Min Son, into the area, this for 3-1! Spurs now have that two-goal cushion, courtesy of Heung-Min Son. Dele Alli, it's for 4! Oh! Another precise finish from Dele Alli. Dele Alli, totally unmarked. His second, Tottenham's fourth. Picked out by Rose, finished by Alli.
Brilliant evening there at St Mary's and a great win for Spurs. Hopefully another one of those coming for Ryan Mason tonight. And I'm delighted to say I'm now joined from pitch side by our club journalist, Milesy. How are you getting on, Milesy?
Oh, good, Ben. How are you, mate?
Yeah, really good. Now, you had the team warming up right behind you. Have they left you just as we've gone live?
Yeah, literally, I was going to jump in and join in. I thought I might have a shot at it, but
now they've gone. They took one look at you on the sideline.
Unfortunately, saw me and legged it.
Oh, mate, what a busy 48 hours, I imagine, for you, but all focus tonight turns to Ryan Mason. What a special moment for him on the touchline.
Oh, it's fantastic, Ben. It's fantastic. I mean, we remember him coming into the club. He was 8 years old. 2008, signed his pro contract in the academy. And I'll tell you what the key one for him, Ben, was we went on tour in 2014 and we're in America. And Maurizio was talking to a few of the press lads after a game or after a training session. And he said, I'll tell you what, lads, I'll tell you the one player who's impressed me the most on this tour so far, and it was Ryan Mason. So there's no surprises come, 3 months later. I think everyone will remember that goal he scored against Forest. He then made his debut at the Emirates against the Arsenal. That was his first Premier League start. And what a player. I mean, he's a fantastic player. Fantastic player in his day. So for him to go full circle, especially after what he's been through, look, he's living the dream. It's the fairy tale, isn't it? Let's just hope it goes well tonight for him.
Yeah, fingers crossed, absolutely. And look, I mean, he's put himself in a great position with that lineup as well. You have to say it's a very attack-minded lineup.
I mean, it looks like Cole's on the menu tonight, doesn't it? I mean, look, Ryan, when we've seen him, his youth teams, always played football, play out from the back, try and get on the front foot, the Spurs way, basically. And but this is a Southampton team who are also, as he said himself, aggressive. They're brave on the ball. They want to play. They've got good players, haven't they, in their team? So, you know, it's an open game. It's an open game. I'm just hoping it goes the same way as it did down at St Mary's. 5-2, we'll take that all night, won't we?
Yeah, we absolutely will. Just tell me, what's your prediction for tonight? How do you think it's going to play out for Ryan?
Well, I think we'll get on the front foot. I think we'll get on. Sorry, the groundsman's over there. He's threatening to throw a ball at me, so he's thrown me there, isn't he? But I think let's get on the front foot, get ahead in the game, and hopefully we'll have too much for him. That's simple as that.
Couldn't agree more, Milesy. I'll see you down there at pitch side. Then fingers crossed for a really good game for you tonight. Some great interviews afterwards.
Let's hope so, mate. All the best, Ben. Take care, pal.
Let's see the most important 11 of the evening and introduce our match day mascots. So here they are saying hello to Sonny a little bit earlier on. This is incredibly sweet. Sonny's always popular, isn't he? You see every week players saying he's one of their... Sorry, mascots saying he's one of their favourite players. But Andrew has gone for Harry Kane. Andrew's 6 years old and he thinks that we're going to win 2-0 tonight. I'll take that all day, Andrew. Next up, we've got Kyla. And Kyla's gone for a 2-1 win. Favourite players are Højbjerg, Lucas and Bale, all on the pitch tonight, which is very exciting. Cody's picked out Sonny and Harry, and Cody thinks that we're going to win 3-1 tonight, which is a great prediction as well. Next up, we've got Ewan. We asked Ewan who you'd like to meet most, and he said the whole Tottenham squad. I love that loyalty to every single player. Would love to meet Sonny and Reguilon, I'm sure, as well. Hayden's picked out Harry Kane as his favourite player, and Hayden thinks that we're going to win 3-1 tonight. There's lots of positivity flowing around this evening, which is fab. We've got Jackson next up. Jackson's 5 years old, and he thinks that we're going to win 2-0, and his favourite player is Harry Kane. Then we've got Mason. Mason, who's 9 years old, would love to meet Sonny more than anyone else in the world, but his favourite players are Sonny, Harry and Gareth. And then next up, we've got Rory. Rory's 10 years old, thinks that we're going to win 3-1 tonight. His favourite player is actually Hugo Lloris, but he's also picked out Harry and Sonny. We've got Zach next up. Zach's 12 years old, thinks that we're going to win 3-1 tonight, which is a very, very popular scoreline. Picked out Harry and Sonny as Evan Tungi as well. Then we've got Dolly. Dolly's our number 10. Has picked out Kane and Bale as the players she'd like to meet more than anyone else. And then our number 11 is Kit S. And Kit has gone for a 3-2 win, lots of goals. That might be the best prediction of the night, you know. And his favourite players are Sonny and Harry. So a massive hello to you all, and hopefully we'll see you back here at the stadium very, very soon. It's almost time for kickoff. Just before we get into the game, let's just get a couple of quick messages from the club. First up, your matchday programmes, you can still get hold of these. So tottenhamhotspur.com/programme to get a digital copy with Vinny on the front there. As well as that, you absolutely should check this out. 30% off the away kit at the moment. We will be wearing this in the League Cup final. So check that out on the club website, where you can also check out 50% off a load of great items in the sale. So check that out, tottenhamhotspur.com as well. Another quick reminder, this weekend, ahead of the League Cup final, we will have another N17 live for you in the morning. So ahead of the game, we'll be live with you in the morning around breakfast time, so you can all come and join us and talk through who we think the team use, who we think is going to be in that team. That's at 11:30 a.m. and then we will have N17 live for you as per usual before the game, about 45 minutes before kickoff. Let's just remind you of how you can follow along tonight alongside the game. Club channels are at Spurs Official for Twitter and Instagram. Make sure you subscribe to the YouTube channel and like the Facebook page as well. On top of that, you should check out the Matchday Centre on the Spurs app. It's really amazing, got so many stats. If you're anything like me, it's so good to watch the game and have that alongside. Or unless you would like to watch our live stream on Twitch. So loads of people getting involved with this, with Bex and Matt watching along on Twitch. So check that out. You can see the link below. And then we'll be back at the end of the game as well. So do make sure that you come back at the end of the game to see all of the post-match reaction with us. Wherever you are in the world tonight, make sure you enjoy the game. Get behind the team. Come on, you Spurs, as always. And let's just remind ourselves that there is no room for racism.
Whether we're in a stadium or not, there's no room for racism. Not out there, not in here. There's no room for racism.
No room for racism.
Anywhere.
Take a knee.
They kneel in unity.
But without actions,
genuinely powerful sides.
There are just words. There's no room for ignorance or intolerance, for hate, for injustice, for sitting in silence, for doing nothing.
I'm ashamed, I'm embarrassed. We want equality in society, in football.
We all need to do more. Challenge it.
CCTV will find the perpetrator of that and he will have a lifetime ban.
Report it. Change it. Premier League. No room for racism. Anywhere.